In Sydney, Colt Turse in today's Bill Stutt Stakes at Moonee Valley. Ridden superbly by Stephen King, Ready to Explode held the slipper winner in the final 200 metres after the favourite had no luck in the running.
On a perfect spring afternoon, there was a big crowd at the Valley for today's program, but unfortunately, they had to contend with a computer malfunction with the tote. However, a late offer by the club of half-price drinks would have eased the discomfort somewhat. Naturally, the centre of attention was Turse, the Triple Crown winner starting an odds-on favourite in the Bill Stutt Stakes. But after having no luck mid-race, the Sydney champ couldn't overcome Ready to Explode.
About to turn the corner, Ready to Explode took the lead. Turse is hard ridden in the middle, coming after it. Then Prince of Brazen, further back, Natchez. Ready to Explode in front. Turse on the inside, trying to wear it down. Ready to Explode's holding on. Turse can't reach it. It's going to be a boil over in the Bill Stutt. Ready to Explode is going to beat Turse by a half length. Third placing in the race went to Our Bold Cruiser and then Roger...
Trainer John Maher was full of praise for Stephen King's ride and says the colt will now be set for the Caulfield Guineas and perhaps the Cox Plate.
He has got the ability to settle and it's been an attractive race for three-year-olds, so holding condition, training on, I'd certainly think so.
And although disappointed to be beaten, the connections of Turse were far from unhappy with the colt's run and said he'll be much harder to beat in the Caulfield Guineas.
The other horse was just too good today. He had his chance to win, but... He'll make a bit men's Cox Plate day when he gets out and gets going at the half mile.
At the 600 second last, you know, and at one stage probably given the lead of six or seven lengths.
Yeah.
Well, it's too hard to do that at Moonee Valley.
American John Kaczynski today won his first ever 500.
Begun with the shock loss by Turse this afternoon at Moonee Valley. Starting a short price favourite in the $250,000 Bill Stutt Stakes, the champion three-year-old was beaten by outsider Ready to Explode. Here's John Russell.
Now Turse is getting a split on the home turner. It's Prince of Praise tackled by Ready to Explode and Turse is in second place as they straighten up. Ready to Explode, the leader. Turse is trying to get to him. Ready to Explode is still in front, halfway down the running. Turse is trying hard. I don't think he'll pick him up. Ready to Explode is going strongly. Ready to Explode will cause a boil over. Ready to Explode by a half length to Turse.
Ready to Explode was written by Stephen King and started 10-1. From Turse, the 9-4 on favourite and Our Bold Cruiser, 80-1.
And finally, Pete, computer problems at the tab. No tabs tonight.
OK, thanks, Andrew. Still to come, Tracy Dale with details of something.
Blade has caused a boil over at Moonee Valley this afternoon by taking out the Bill Stutt Stakes. The 58th running of the event, formerly the Moonee Valley Stakes, saw Turse going for 9 in a row. Here's 3 years in to Brian Martin, call of the finish.
Ready to Explode, coming at it quickly from Roger John, and now Turse is out. Turse gets away from the fence, he gets clear now, Die Ready to Explode moved up to take the lead. Turse, Die has to pull the whip now, a half away at the 200 metre mark and they've come away from Natchez. It's Ready to Explode in front. Now Turse is knuckling down, can he bridge the gap? I don't think he can. Ready to Explode's a length in front. He's holding the Sydney colt at bay and Ready to Explode is one and a half length to Turse.
And a good fourth in the Ascot Vale certainly appointed to that win and the extra distance suiting. The margin's 3/4 by 3 and a top ride by Stephen King. Now today's major TAB dividends are still unavailable owing to a major computer breakdown. The combinations you need are 7 and 5 for the extra double. The daily double, you need 1 and 2. And the quadrella, you'll get a return for 5, 1, 1, or 5, 1, 2, and today's quad extra, 1, 2, and 10. And for tonight, Mitch, that is all in sport. I'm still in grand final mode, so I'm going home with them an early night.
Yes, some big celebration.
Wayne Gardner and McDuin. Kevin McGee made a successful return, finishing 6th. Boom Sydney three-year-old Turse was beaten on his merits at Moonee Valley today. The colt started well in the red, but connections couldn't find an excuse for his second to Ready to Explode. The crowd was up about 2,000, but because of a major tote malfunction, betting turnover was down $1.2 million, costing the club plenty. The first today, and it was Art Style, the winner. A bit too classy for Yerangi, scoring at 7-2. Thalira got home for Spike Short in the second, running one of the popular ones at 11-2. The third went to Spanish Gem, appreciating the firmer track, and came home very strongly to beat Boracha and Listark. The Stutt Stakes, race 4. The Melbourne Spring is looking for a star. Most thought Turse would go close to earning the champion tag by the end of next month, but that came to a halt at Moonee Valley. Turse, going for win number 9 in a row, jumped well, but relinquished his advantage at the first turn and had to come from an awkward place on the rails. In the meantime, Stephen King was off and running on Ready to Explode.
Explode in front by a length. Turse, Die has him under the whip. He's 3/4 behind. Ready to Explode in front. Turse will have to find something, but Ready to Explode is in front with about 50 metres to go. Ready to Explode. Explode is holding Terse and Ready to Explode beats Terse a half length. Two and a half lengths, Our Bold Cruiser got up for third.
Shane Dye could offer no excuses.
No, not at all. The other horse was just too good today. He had his chance to win. But he'll make a men's Cox Plate day when he gets out and gets going at the half mile.
Terse didn't sprint home at the end. Perhaps he needs more ground.
Shane said he worked home good, as if he wants a mile or a mile and a quarter. So that was all right. It's a shame he didn't win. The pedigree suggests that that he should, if he's suited.
So this long term is the Cox Plate.
Well, it is now, Clem.
Ready to Explode started at 10-1. Next stop is the Cox Plate. Terse will continue into the Guineas, Cox Plate and Derby. The Eagles were crushed yesterday, but a Caulfield Cup claim was made by Top Perth Day of the Hippogriff.
The Hippogriff broke away at the top of the straight. The Hippogriff in front, round the turn from Ritual Style. Lord Chicton and then Rashik tighten for room. The Hippogriff in front. Lord Chicton and Rashik are bumping. It's the Hippogriff in front of Lord Chicton. JD's Bandit late on the outside. The Hippogriff in front of Rashik nearing the line. And the Hippogriff's going to win it by about three quarters, Rashik. Third is Lord Chicton.
Oh, he's a very good horse. He holds three track records in Perth. You know, and when he's right, he just keeps trying, he'll just try his heart out, you know.
The Hippogriff started at the remarkable odds of 10-1. He drops 5 kilos to 51 in the Caulfield Cup. Yuma Tiller found the firm track to his liking in the next.
Yuma Tiller's travelling all right today round the turn and takes the lead. It's Yuma Tiller into the straight from Roxy Dancer by about a half a length. A couple then Channel Command and on with it. Yuma Tiller in front of Roxy Dancer halfway down the running. He'll break back today and Yuma Tiller's going further ahead. Yuma Tiller scores by about 3.5 lengths to Roxy Dancer on with it third.
Yuma Tiller with David Taggart aboard started at 3-1. Roxy Dancer was favourite, on with it third at 10-1. The Hayes stable finally had some luck in the next.
Round the turn they run now, and here Pacific out wide went to the lead from Shivano Miss and Folklore Lass. Right down the outside is Blame finishing well. It's Pacific in front though, with about 50 or 60 to go. Pacific is clear of Blame, and Pacific will go on and win it. Pacific scores by 2 lengths on the post to a photo between Blame and Rockets Galore, the miners.
And it was Pacific at 10-1 for Peter Hutchinson. Rockets Galore is ready to win. And the last event went to Disputed Pearl. Also starting at 10-1, Damien Oliver. First day back from a suspension, straight into the winner's list. And because of a problem with the tote, dividends for the exotic bets won't be known until about 10 o'clock tonight, Arthur. Not that it worries me.
No, me either. No, nowhere near. Thanks, Greg. Now let's have a look at the weather, and conditions were fine.